President Marcos creates a committee that will address land acquisition issues to speed up big-ticket rail projects. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista says the creation of the Interagency Committee for Right-of-Way Activities for National Railway Projects is a huge boost to the railway sector. Bautista will serve as the body's chairman, with the Secretary of the Department of Human Settlements and Urban Development as co-chair. Ongoing rail projects like the MRT3 and the Metro Manila Subway have faced challenges due to land acquisition issues. Cebu City now under a state of water crisis. Mayor Michael Rama made the declaration Tuesday, with 28 villages under a state of calamity due to the effects of the El Nino phenomenon. Farmlands have dried up, crops have withered, and residents are scrambling for ration from water trucks. The city council is now looking at tapping alternative water sources and the construction of a dam. Cebu's heat index reached 38 degrees Celsius Monday, and according to the latest forecast, the mercury is expected to climb to 39 degrees Celsius there today, Tuesday.
The White House press corps got a good laugh on April 1st as they were greeted by a giant Easter bunny during the White House press briefing. Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre stood alongside a bunny, saying the White House would revoke the Hatch Act, which prohibits federal employees from using their official capacity to affect or interfere with elections. It was all part of an April Fool's prank. The White House also pulled off such stunts in previous April Fool's days. Back in 2013, it posted a fake video message from the kid president addressing the nation from his own White House lectern.
An executive of Ismin Developer Cebu Landmasters expects the company to log the same growth momentum for this year. Cebu Landmasters CFO Grant Cheng told ANC the challenge is to not grow too fast, but to grow sustainably. He also teased an upcoming project, their first foray in Luzon.
We're looking at around 12 projects this year. We're expanding into new markets like Butuan and General Santos. And we haven't been shy in saying that we have an eye towards expanding in Luzon. We're engaged with certain landowners so that we could start making inquiries and, in fact, making moves towards acquisitions and developments there. The total value of those 12 projects should be north of 20 billion. Talks are serious. The intention is there. We've put in time and resources to explore some very serious and, frankly, some very exciting opportunities. We'll probably raise some eyebrows when they find out who exactly we're going to partner with and where. Hopefully an announcement this year.
A former spokesperson of President Rodrigo Duterte says the former president never entered into a so-called gentleman's agreement with China over the Ayungin Shoal. Attorney Salvador Panelo says he talked to Duterte about it and he denied forging a deal with China. Panelo adds whoever made the claim only wants publicity. It was another former Duterte spokesman, Attorney Harry Roque, who revealed the deal. Roque said Panelo is correct because the agreement was not specific to Ayungin Shoal.
The gentleman's agreement is to respect the status quo on the entire West Philippine Sea dispute. Mm-hmm. So that is correct. I do not deny that. And that is why I am, in fact, surprised that what has been coming out in the media is a sellout of sorts.
Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro demanding accountability for that supposed gentleman's agreement. But he says the country must also not lose sight of China's illegal activities in the West Philippine Sea. China has repeatedly cited the alleged deal to put the blame on the Philippines over the worsening tension in the West Philippine Sea. But Teodoro claims Beijing is using the deal to refocus the debate away from their illegal activities in the disputed waterway.